Welcome to the Grace Cup Ministry. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Come on and rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be here today. Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. And today we have with us the minister, Antwan Hunter, and he's from the New Jerusalem Baptist Church. Reverend Curtis Johnson Jr. is the pastor. And of course, we have prayer with the Reverend Ella MacDonald, Kingdom Building Ministry. Let us pray.
Let us pray. Father God, as again we come, we thank you for grace and mercy today. Father, we thank you for your goodness from everlasting to everlasting. You are God. Yes. And Father, we thank you for this day, for this thank is the day you, that God. You have made, and we shall rejoice and be glad yes. in it. Thank Father, you. We just thank you for another opportunity to come on Grace Cup today. Yes, and Lord, just speak you, a word Lord. That somebody might hear from you today. Yes. Lord, we thank you. Father, we ask you to bless those that are going through today, Lord. Yes, Lord. Whatever they're going through, whether they're sick, Lord, yes. in the hospital, yes. the nursing home, Lord, mm-hmm. behind prison wall, Lord, mm-hmm. whatever going on, we ask you to touch, heal, and deliver. Lord, we thank you for grace and mercy thank today. You, Father, we ask you to bless the man of God as a word come forth, yes. that somebody might hear a word from you and give their life to you. Mm-hmm. Father, we thank you for what you're going to do on this program today. In the precious, mighty name of Jesus, we pray, amen, and thank God.
Hallelujah. Amen and praise Hallelujah. God. And the word says men ought to always pray. Amen. And now let's hear from Arian Fleming with a song. And after the song, we will hear from Minister Hunter. God bless you.
You don't have to worry. And don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning, and troubles, they don't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand. No test and trials, they seem to get you down, and all your friends and loved ones are nowhere to be found. Remember, there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know. His hand. Oh, I know that I on my way. My life is in his hands. My life is in his hands. Oh, my life is in his hands. My life is in his hands. My life is in his hands. Oh, my life is in his hands.
Good afternoon. It is in the name of our risen Lord and Savior Jesus Christ that we greet you today. We're so glad that you tuned in to the broadcast. We hope that something is said that will impact and bless your life today. I am not going to be before you very long, but there is a word from the Lord today. Those of you that have your Bibles, if you would open them to the second book of the Gospels, which is the book of Mark. And we'll be in the 5th chapter. For the sake of brevity, I'm going to read from the 39th to the 43rd verse. And when he has come in, he saith unto them, why make ye this ado and weep? The damsel is not dead, but sleepeth. And they laughed him to scorn. But when he had put them all out, he taketh the father and the mother of the damsel, and them that were with him, and entered in where the damsel was laying. And he took the damsel by the hand and said unto her, Talitha kumai, which is being interpreted, damsel, I say unto thee, arise. And straightway the damsel arose and walked, for she was the age of 12 years, and they were astonished with a great astonishment. And he charged them straightly that no man should know it, and commanded that something should be given to her to eat. My brothers and sisters, I want to give you a word from the Lord from this thought. It's not over. Father God, we thank you for this day, Lord God. We ask that you touch now those that are watching this broadcast, Lord God. Lord God, we ask that you open up their hearts and their minds, Lord God, that you will give them something that will let them know that you are in control, Lord God, and that they can make it. They can stand on your word, Father God. Father God, we ask that through it all that you be glorified, Lord God. You have your way, Lord God. We thank you now for your darling son, Jesus Christ. In the name of your son, Christ Jesus, we pray. Amen. Often it is easy to become discouraged by the situations that we face in life. It is easy to allow the enormity and the darkness and the graveness of the crisis that we go through dictate how we respond. And my brothers and sisters, in those times, it is two paths that we can go down. It's two critical choices that we have to make. We can either choose to be the victim. We can choose to lay down and give up and not want to go on. Or we can choose to be the victors. We often have that choice to say that this is not where I want to be right now. It doesn't look good right now. It's rough right now. It's a little dark right now. And Lord, be honest, I feel like thrown in the towel. But something ought to stir up in our spirit that says that no matter how big the problem is, my God is bigger. No matter what we go through, that our God is able to bring us through. And so we ought to be able to say, yes, it is rough right now. And yes, it is dark right now. And yes, this hurts right now. But I will go on. I will live. I will live and not die. I will live to declare the works of the Lord. And in our text right here, we have a young ruler named Jairus, and Jairus' daughter is at the point of death. And finding out that, you know, his daughter is at the point of death, he goes now to seek Jesus. And while he is on his way back with Jesus to have him look over his daughter, he's interrupted by the woman with the issue of blood. And that's good news, because on the way to having my miracle fulfilled, I know that God is able to perform miracles today. That's how wondrous and great our God is. He gets to where his daughter is laying, and then he's greeted by naysayers and doubters. They come and tell him, Jairus, why are you bothering the father? Why are you bothering Jesus anymore? Your daughter is now dead. And we have to be weary and mindful of people that always want to bring us negative things. We have to be weary and mindful of people that always want to bring us mess. We always have to be wary of those that come in our face and want to speak gloom and doom. They never have anything wonderful to say. They always want to bring me gossip and trash. It is something to be said that they always have to bring it to you, and you're not a trash can. So how is it that you take on the negative stuff? And the thing about it is, if they're talking about those people, what are they saying to you about you behind your back? What are they saying about you when you're not there? And I would just want to invite somebody and tell somebody that if somebody is talking about you and if they have something to say about you, you look them right in their face and tell them, if you want to talk about me, then pray for me. If you want to keep my name in your mouth, then go to God and tell them that I need him every hour. They tell him, Jairus, your daughter is dead. But Jesus turns to Jairus, and he overhears what they say to him, and he turns to Jairus and he says, Jairus, all I need for you to do is not be afraid. Only believe in what I told you. Jesus knows that the enemy is now in Jairus' ear. Jesus knows that the enemy is trying to plant doubt in Jairus' mind. But Jesus said, all you have to do is be not afraid. The Bible says that God has not given us the spirit of fear, but a peace of love and a sound mind. And not only does he tell Jairus, don't you be afraid, but he says, believe. And that's something that we have to do as Christian believers. We have to stand on the word of God and believe that if God did it this time, if God did it for us the last time, if God brought us through before, if God made a way for us the last time, that God will and is able to do it again. Jesus suffered no man to follow him. He points to Peter and James and John, the brother of James, to come with him. Because he said, I don't need a crowd around me. I don't need a lot of people around me to do what I'm going to do. And you have to understand that not a lot of people are able to be around you. There's going to be some folks that aren't going to be able to stand with you. There's going to be some folks that aren't going to be around to handle what you're about to receive in your destiny. And he came to the house of Jairus, and he saw that everybody there was weeping. The mother was weeping, and relatives were crying. And Jesus looked at them all, and he asked, why do you make this ado? Why are you weeping? Why are you crying? This damsel is not dead, but she is sleeping. And I need to tell somebody that and ask you the critical question, why are you still weeping? Why are you still lamenting over something that God has said that is not dead? It may not look like it's going to work out right now. It may not look like you're going to be able to get through right now. But you serve an almighty God that has the power to bring you through and pull you through. He looks at her and says, she's not dead. She's sleeping. And those that were around him began to laugh. And my brother and sister, I want to tell you that they laughed because they saw the young damsel in the physical. They saw that there was no life left in her. They saw that her chest compressions weren't going up and down. They saw that her eyes was not blinking. They saw that she could not respond to what they were saying to her. And they began to laugh because they could not see beyond the right now. But Jesus looked at the young lady, and he looked past what they considered dead. He looked past everything, every fault that the young lady had. He looked past everything that the young lady had done in her life. He was able to look inside of her, past the dead situation, and see the best in the young lady. And that's what I want to tell somebody today, that the Lord is now looking past all of your faults. He's looking past all of your flaws. He's looking past your drug abuse. He's looking past your promiscuity. He's looking past all of those things that kept you away from him. He's looking past all of that and seeing the best in you. They laughed, and Jesus puts them out. He said, if you want to hate and not celebrate, get out. If you can't see where I'm about to take this young lady, if you can't see the destiny that is on her life, get out. You can't stay. And that's why I want to tell somebody today that the Lord is about to perform a divine amputation. He's about to cut out and cut off some people from your life. If they cannot hang with you and they cannot go to where you're going, if they cannot celebrate what God is doing in your life, if they cannot push you into a place that where God is trying to take you to, then they have to go. They have to get out. But here is the key, my brothers and sisters. Who the Lord cuts out, we cannot go back and get. You can't text. You can't tweet. You can't call. You can't email. You can't Twitter. You can't go back and get what the Lord has put out. Let them go. They are not designed to handle your destiny. Jesus takes the mother and the father into the room. And he says, and he takes the damsel by the hand. And he speaks a word over the young lady. The Bible said that he said, Talitha kumai, which is being interpreted, damsel, I say unto thee, arise. In other words, he's saying to this child, get up from the situation that you're in now. You're not going to stay in the same situation that you're in. I know it looks dead to those that are around you, but you are not going to stay in this situation. I want to speak a word into this generation now that it is time for you to arise. You're not going to stay in the same situation that you're in. You're not going to stay in the same drug use that you're in. You're not going to stay in the same abusive relationship that you're in. You're not going to stay in the same poverty that you're in. You're not going to stay in the same unemployment that you're in. You're not going to sit and stay in the same dead-end job. The Lord is saying to you right now, you need to rise up. The Bible says that straightway the damsel arose. In other words, she got up quickly. And I want to tell somebody that today is your day to get up. Not tomorrow, not yesterday, but today is your day of getting up. The Bible says that when she got up, she walked. And this is an interesting thing about that is she walked. Here it is that this young lady was dead. She was stuck in this situation. But now she is rising up and she's walked. What the walking signifies is that she is moving forward. She is moving past what was in her past. And I want to tell somebody that you have to get ready to move forward. I understand that, you know, you had some things that was behind you in your past, and there were some struggles. There were some things that you didn't know that if you was going to be able to get over. But I want to invite someone out there right now to just lay hands on yourself and that God is going to help me get past my past. He's going to help me get past those things that are behind me. The Bible says that we press towards the mark. In other words, we are walking towards the prize, which is in the high calling of Christ Jesus. It says that the young lady was the age of 12, and they were astonished with great astonishment. They thought that she was always going to be like this. They thought that there was no way that Jesus could pull her out. And I want to say to somebody that there are naysayers around you that don't think that you're going to come out of this. If they had their way, you would stay in it. You know the thing? Because they don't understand that God is a good God, that he blesses all the time. And they can't handle where he's about to take you. See, it's good when you're on the same level as them. It's good when you're in the same situation as them. But the moment that God elevates you and brings you up out of it, that's when you acquire haters. But all I have to say to you on that is you let a hater hate on, because God is getting ready to do great and wonderful things. He charged them straightly that no man should know it. And that was an interesting thing, because here it is that Jesus tells them, don't tell anybody. And that's hard for us that have been blessed. It's hard for us to contain. It's hard for us to be quiet. And I decided, and I studied, why, Lord, would you want them not to say anything? And he gave me this. He said, her just being there is the testimony alone. The fact that she is now still standing. You don't have to sit and say anything, but the fact that you got up out of the situation that you were in, the fact that you are still breathing, the fact that you are still able to do what it is that God has for you to do, the fact that you came out of poverty. Yes, you're in a recession, but the lights is still on. You still got gas in the car. You still have food on the table. The fact that you are here is a testimony alone. And he charged them and said that, give the young lady something to eat. And I was dealing with that, and I said, well, Lord, why would you want the young lady to get fed? And he said, Antwan, simply this, when it is that you eat something, when it is that you are weak and tired in your body and you eat something, you gain the nourishment from it. In other words, you get the strength back from whatever it is that you eat. And what the Lord was trying to tell me to tell you today is that you got to get ready to get your strength back. I know you went through some situations that left you weak. I know you went through some situations that left you hurt. I know you went through some situations that left you with scars. It left you wondering if you would ever make it out of it. It left you wondering, where are my family and my friends? Why are they so few and far in between? But the Lord told me to tell you that don't worry about them, because in your weakness is my strength made perfect. And he told me that you ought to get ready to just stand. You ought to get ready to move out of the situation that you're in. It's not over for you. Some people that spoke the gloom and doom are not going to have to eat their words. Those people that sat and watched you struggle and watched you go through and said to you that you're not going to make it out of it, I'm here to tell you that the devil is a lie. You are going to make it out of it by the word of the Lord. My brothers and sisters, I want to invite you now, if you have not made the critical decision to invite Jesus Christ into your life, we want you now to get yourself into a Bible-believing, Bible-teaching church. The time is winding down for all of us, and the Lord is on his way back soon. Don't let it be said too late for you. If there's plenty of churches in the city, plenty of pastors, and someone can get you to where you need to be. I just want to thank you. I want to let you know that God loves you, that heaven is praying for you, and that may the good Lord keep you.
Don't have to worry, and don't you be afraid. Joy comes in the morning, and troubles, they don't last always. For there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know tests and trials, they seem to get you down, and all your friends and loved ones are nowhere to be found. Remember, there's there's a friend named Jesus who will wipe your tears away. And if your heart is broken, just lift your hands and say, oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand, no matter what may come my way. My life is in his hand. Oh, with Jesus I can take it. With him I know I can stand, no matter what may come my way. My life is in his hand. Oh, I know that I can make it. I know that I can stand, no matter what may come my way.